first thing that I always say is entrepreneurship is all about what the most important thing is, energy and enthusiasm. So before I start my session, we'll have a practice of energy and enthusiasm. Because between dreams and destiny, a lot of people will come and say, "Nahi ho sakta hai." In fact, investors, families, friends, first vendor, first banker, sab jan yahi bolenge, ye cheez ho nahi sakta hai. The only thing that can carry you between dreams to destiny is, you know what? Energy. So energy comes from a beautiful Latin word called enthusiasm. And in Latin, enthusiasm has got a beautiful meaning. En means inside and tu means God. Andar ka bhagwan ko jaga do, to tum aur tumhare maksad ke beech mein koi nahi aa sakta hai. Can you have a big round of energetic clap? Thank you. The next 1 hour, whatever I'm going to talk, every 5 minutes, if something has touched your heart, all of you as entrepreneurs will do only one thing, demonstrate your energy and enthusiasm. Jo aadmi taali bhi nahi maar sakta hai, wo apne sapna kya sakar karega. No, that's a challenge. The first and the most important thing for me is inspiration. What is it? Inspiration. We all go to school, we go to college, we collect a lot of information. But information is like that diesel and petrol in the car. Jab tak us gaadi ko chabi nahi lagta hai, tab tak us gaadi ko momentum nahi milta hai. Jab tak jindagi mein inspiration nahi milta hai, aadmi ka life ko ek naya turn aur twist nahi milta hai. To inspiration, how many of you heard about Paulo Coelho? It's such a beautiful and wonderful book. You have a dream. The dream has come in the womb of the universe. It is the responsibility of the universe to fulfill the dream. The universe conspires to help you achieve your dream. Beautiful and wonderful. And whatever Paulo Coelho has said, the same thing our own Mahatma Gandhi has said. You find the purpose, the means will follow. For entrepreneurship, for any person, what we require is purpose in life. And how many of you have read about Richard Bach, Jonathan Livingstone, the seagull? Oh, I can see 4 or 5 hands. Beautiful. When I was 18 years old, I happened to chance read this book. And such a beautiful book. Jonathan Livingstone is a book written by Richard Bach. And Jonathan is our hero in this book. It's a story of seagulls. Seagulls normally don't fly much in the air. Their flight is restricted to food. 10 se 15 feet ki uchai pe udte hai. Middle class people, PF, gratuity. Ek chota sa ghar Pune mein, okay, maybe one more house, second house, and ek imported gaadi shayad, you know, any of this, not the Maruti one, a little more, and Switzerland mein family ke saath chale jao, aur Facebook mein photo dal do, jindagi ka maksad pura ho gaya. And Jonathan looks at the eagle, jo 1000 feet ki uchai pe udte hai, the Tatas, the Birlas, the McDonald, the Colgate Palmolive of the world, the Velamuris of the world, and who have achieved so much of success, Narayan Murthy's, and says, can I too fly like them? Can I too fly like them? But there is a fictional story. Ek 1000 feet ka mountain hai, and seagull's life is restricted to eating the dead fish on the seashore. And their life is restricted to fight amongst their friends for the dead fishes. Jonathan looks at this whole thing. I want to experience flight. Like a middle class boy saying, मरमर के जीना थोड़ी जीना होता है. आई वॉन्ट टू एक्सपीरियंस लाइफ एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप एंड चेज माई ड्रीम. एंड जोनाथन क्लाइम्स दिस फिक्शनल माउंटेन 1000 फीट की ऊंचाई पे. वहां से यू लुक्स एट द ईगल लाइक ए मिडिल क्लास बॉय लुकिंग एट द टाटास द बिरलास द इन्फोसिस और द बियानीज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड एंड सेइंग कैन आई बिल्ड अ बिजनेस लाइक देम. बट इट रिक्वायर्स अ लॉट ऑफ करेज टू गिव अप योर सिक्योर्ड जॉब टू गिव अप योर सिक्योर्ड फैमिली बिजनेस टू गिव अप वॉट एवर यू आर डूइंग and to chase your dreams. And Jonathan looks at the eagle 1 day, 2 day, 10 day, and maybe 6 months. And one day he gathers the courage and throws himself from that 1,000 feet high cliff. He doesn't know how to handle 1,000 feet. And he comes crashing on the brick-like ocean. He becomes unconscious. And the waves brings him back to the shore. His family, his friends, they all say, Bola tha na, ek chota sa middle class job dhoondlo Infosys mein, ya ICICI mein. एक घर लेना था शादी करना था हमारा जिंदगी का मकसद पूरा हो जाता था. जोनाथन सेज नो फादर नो मदर आई नो हाउ टू कैन फ्लाई लाइक द ईगल आई वांट टू चेज माय ड्रीम एंड ही क्लाइम्स दैट फिक्शनल माउंटेन थ्रोज हिमसेल्फ सेकंड टाइम थर्ड टाइम टेंथ टाइम एंड वन डे जोनाथन flew like an eagle. That's the story of all entrepreneurs. 15 years I spent in corporate finance. I met small, big, medium entrepreneurs. My job was only to go to the banks and raise money for them. And amongst them was one Kishore Biyani. And I saw a stupid dream at 50 crores turnover, what has translated into a 10,000 crores empire. Many of them. But the only thing that I can say as entrepreneurs is you have to chase your dreams, explore, fail many times, and one day you will fly like Jonathan. Can we have a big round of applause for inspiration? Big one. Now I am coming to this beautiful thing, idea. Inspiration to ho gaya hai, but karna kya hai? Har ek aadmi idea dhoondta hai. That is a big idea that I want to chase, you know? And my mobile ringtone used to be this famous song. Chodo kal ki baate, kal ki baat punani, naye dor mein likhenge, hum milkar nahi kaani, hum Hindustani. Sunai? Sunil that song? Am Hindustani, huh? And I used to start the day with a Colgate paste, am Hindustani. A Gillette blade, am Hindustani. A Lux soap, am Hindustani. A cross pen, and I used to wonder, is my Hindustan kahan hai bhai? And somewhere that tricked me was, I should build an Indian brand. I should build an Indian brand. So brand mein kare to kya kare? You know, soap mein to pura Unilever ne cha liya hai. All detergents, all soaps. Paste mein Colgate cha gaya hai. Blade mein Gillette. To sab jagah pe to transnational, multinational hai. Kare to kya kare? And those days the Kellogg CEO was my neighbor. And somewhere in his send-off party he muttered, I asked him, Kellogg's kyun chod rahe ho? He muttered, kuch bhi karo yaar, Hindustani aadmi desi hi kata hai. I could see a multinational food company CEO's frustration. And I could see an opportunity for me. 100 crores plus population, weakness for spicy Indian food. Pehenne ke liye wo log koi bhi shirt pehen lenge, international shirt. You know, juta bhi Nike ka juta, cross ka pen, Ray-Ban ka sunglasses. But khate samay, they all crave for spicy Indian food. Now that I saw was a great opportunity. 100 crores population, even 50 crore population target kar lo. You know, jiske paas kaafi paisa hai, 50 crore ke paas to utna paisa hi nahi hai. And us 50 crore ko ek 10 rupaya ka item khila do, 500 crore ka business to khada ho gaya. Saal mein 10 baar 10 rupaya ka item khila do, 5000 crore ka opportunity. I think as entrepreneurs, we have to look at opportunity rather than anything. Can we have a big round of applause for opportunity? Opportunity and opportunity. Why Vada Pav? Why Vada Pav? I was a Tamil Brahmin, you know, and idli was top on my priority. You know, Madrasi logo ko idli bahut pasand hai. And still thinking biryani, you know, but Vada Pav was never there on my mind. And kare to kya kare? And because India is a very large country, you know, what is that food that can bind us together? North is a aloo paratha country, south is a idli dosa country, west is a ragda petis belpuri. Kare to kya kare? And outside VT station one day, I saw this huge McDonald's ka board, 1999 I suppose, 40 feet ka banner tha, and ek 40 feet ka burger ka photograph tha, itna bada memory hai. And kahi pe udari, you know, around 6 o'clock or 5:36 in the evening, there was that Mumbai ka kaka, tela wala, you know. We have that tela with the banyan and lenga, what we call in Mumbai language. Chappan tikli banyan, 56 holes in the banyan, you know, the poor man selling vada pav, you know. We used to eat vada pav and count those holes on his banyan. And I would have picked up my vada pav, still thinking about biryani and idli dosa. And somewhere as I picked up my vada pav, it looked like a twin brother ki story, Ram or Sham ki kahani. That was anything between buns, this was anything between pav. That was mayonnaise, this was chutney. That was lettuce, this was chili. And kahi to aisa lag raha tha ki dono bhai mein se ek bhai America chala gaya, 40,000 plus outlet, jaisa mele mein bichad jate, aur ek bhai aaj bhi Mumbai ke sadak mein sad raha hai, you know. So it looked like that Bollywood movie scene. Thank you. Hey, everybody, everybody there. So I think entrepreneurship is all about celebration. Huh? Life is a series of celebration. If you ask me why you have to celebrate, boss, I got two hands and two legs. I am alive now. I got two meals in the morning. You know, I got a small family. For everything, life is a series of celebration. So one thing, whether we do entrepreneurship or anything, but celebration is very important. Har vakt kush rehna chahiye, har vakt taali marna chahiye, aur jindagi maza, maza, maza bolna chahiye. In that name, can we have that big round of celebration? Big one. So it looked like a typical Bollywood, you know, Ram or Shyam ki kahani. And not only in terms of form, as entrepreneurs, we should go beyond form. Form is what we see. And there is something called content. There is something called content. And India is changing. India is changing. The woman is working and the kitchen is shrinking. All together, huh? India is changing, woman is working, kitchen is shrinking. You know? Imagine there is a 25-year-old boy who does engineering from Pune, MBA from Pune, and goes to work in Infosys in Bangalore. And he gets married to one more girl from Infosys, who is also 25 years old. Both of them are working from morning to evening, projects hai, busy hai. Sunday ke din Pune se 10 uske dost log aa jate college ke to Bangalore. Uski jurrat hogi uski biwi ko bolne ke liye sabke liye khana banao? Nahi na? Agar jurrat dikhaye to bhi divorce ho jayega. So that's the kind of India that we are going in. So entrepreneurship is all about society is changing and the entrepreneur sees an opportunity. So in this changing India, sabke liye time hai, but khane ke liye time nahi hai. We have stores in Gorakhpur, we have stores in Basti. Imagine Gorakhpur mein koi mujhe bolta hai, Venkat ji, mere paas ek hi ghanta, ek ghante ke baad hamara meeting wind up ho jayega. Imagine Gorakhpur mein koi bol raha hai. Earlier only Bombay mein log bolte the. Sabke liye time hai, khane ke liye time nahi hai. So 5 minute mein aap 50 masala dosa customer ko service kar paoge? Nahi na. 5 minute mein 50 pani puri customer ko service kar paoge? Nahi. 5 minute mein Bombay nahi to Pune mein aad gaadi se kade se 50 vada zarur nikal jata hai, paav ke beech mein gusad ke de do. It falls into a definition of a fast food. What is it? Fast food. Second, it's a finger food. If it is idli and dosa, what do you require? Sambar and chutney. If you require sambar and chutney, you require plate and spoon. If there is plate and spoon, what do you require? Table and chair. Agar table or chair aa gaya, to imagine real estate cost. Kitna mehenga hai? Imagine 18 varshat ek jodpa ala, ani aankho mein aake dal ke ek ghanta 10 rupaye ka item khaya, to business ka to band bach jayega. That is the kind of thought process I had. Thank you, and thank you for being such an enthusiastic audience. Fast food, finger food. And that's why Vada Pav is called a finger food. Aap Bombay mein dekha hoga, life and death situation, Kalyan to VT, we will travel. Thane station ke baar latakte rehenge, life and death situation, but aath mein Vada Pav jurur hota hai. Can you do it with a masala dosa? Can you do it with a grilled sandwich? Can you do it with any other pani puri? No. So that's why fast food, finger food and mobile food is very important for a changing India, where everything is becoming fast. You know, railway station, metro, फिर क्या underground क्या क्या कर रहे हैं नो फॉर दिस फास्ट सिटी एंड वड़ा पाव इज नॉट ओनली गॉट दिस लॉट ऑफ माई फ्रेंड्स यूज टू से वेंकी वड़ा पाव बंबई के बाहर चलेगा क्या वड़ा पाव बंबई के बाहर चलेगा क्या एंड समवेयर आई फेल्ट एज एंटरप्रेन्योर्स वी डोंट गो बाय फॉर्म बाय कंटेंट उसके अंदर क्या है पोटेटो एंड व्हीट ओके नॉर्थ में आलू पराठा में क्या है पोटेटो साउथ में मसाला डोसा में क्या है पोटेटो समोसे में क्या है पोटेटो फिंगर चिप्स में क्या है पोटेटो लेज में क्या है पोटेटो Potato has got a very universal appeal. How many people in this audience says, I don't like potato? Ek galti se haath uthaya, khidki ke bahar fek do. That is the kind of initial. And it's also got besan. You know, Aldiram ne thoda sa besan ko tel mein dala, masala lagaya, 1,000 crore ka empire khada ho gaya. That is the kind of business it got it. So somewhere we say, yeah, everybody can clap, everybody. Entrepreneurship need not be serious, huh? It can be fun. So there is a humorous way to look at your own business, you know. So looking at all this, I felt Vada Pav was like Amitabh Bachchan. You know, 60 saal mein agar wo flop hoke bhi gir gaya, Bofors, Bifors, ABCL, but KBC hoke khada ho jata hai. Your product should have that natural pull, dam hona chahiye. Your business idea or your product, your entrepreneur mein dam hona chahiye. Kitne baar bhi gir jaya, phir se khada hone ki taakat hona chahiye. That's why we call, I somehow felt Vada Pav was like Amitabh Bachchan. So your product should have a natural pull. Why brand name Goli? This is the last stage I'm coming for the idea. And a lot of my friends came from advertising, Lintas, HTA, and they all used to say, Venky, English is aspirational. What is it? English is aspirational. Angreji naam hona chahiye. Have you heard about a sari shop in Chennai called Nalli Sari? Huh? Ya Paneri Sari in Dadar? Imagine, you call Nalli Sari, Juli Sari. Is it possible? Ya Paneri Sari, Juli Sari. Bikega? Angreji naam. Murugan Sidli is also a famous store in Coimbatore. Can you call it Peter Sidli? Can you call Aldiram's Bhujia, Sam's Bhujia? Ya can you call Joshi Vada Pav ko Mike's Vada Pav? It doesn't gel. Angreji Mari hota hai, Desi Kari hota hai. Angreji Mari hota hai, desi kari hota hai. And Vada Pav was born on the footpath of Mumbai. And Mumbai has got a language. You know what is Mumbai's language? Pudi, Rapchik, Item, Munnabai, Goli. And that's why we call it Goli Vada Pav. Can we have that big round of applause? So right now I'm coming to the third stage, which is the action. The first I said was bhakti, passion. Then I said jnana, knowledge. And the third is what? Karma, action. Jindagi ka sabse important kaam hota hai karma, 80%. Baki Excel sheet mein baithke, chadar ke beech mein sapne to koi bhi dekh sakta hai. So I think the most important thing is action. And we did our first store in Kalyan. And the moment we did this first store, red means garam garam batata vada, white is cleanliness. And Kalyan ke bagal mein there is a place called what, you know, Ulasnagar. And Ulasnagar is full of these rooms, Sindhis. And I still didn't knew what was, the franchising was in my mind. I had just started a store and thinking we will do franchising maybe after a year's time or something like that. And within the first week, I had all my Sindhi brothers from Ulasnagar coming and saying, Venkat bhai, franchise kabhi de rahe ho? And I still didn't think franchising. And luckily, I used to work for a company called Apple in 1989-90, Aptech. And that Ganesh Natarajan, Atul Nishar company. And I had this old franchise agreement, you know. So, jahan bhi Aptech likha tha, usko maine goli kar diya. Aur jahan bhi computer education likha tha, usko vada pav banake de diya. So, the meaning is, ek baar decide kar liya, to kya bolna hai? Action mein utar jana hai. Okay? Phir baith ke, phir lawyer se agreement banao yani. Lot of my franchises came and said, sir, isme computer, peripherals, books, kya likha hai karke. Bola, jo bhi likha hai, le lo karke. You know? And that's how we started the first store in Kalyan. And the moment we did this store, we had some 300 inquiries and 15 franchises started in Ulasnagar and those areas those days. And this was a central kitchen those days we did. Raat ko 10 baje potato boil ho jata tha, 12 baje peel ho jata tha, 3 baje tak goliya ban jati thi, sabere 5 baje tak gaadiyon mein kacha goli ka masala, you know, chala jata tha. That's how we used to do. Some 50 boys used to work. This was the logistics those days. What we call is pilot. Mind to market. What do you call? Mind to market. Mind mein toh bapko achcha dikhta hai, you know. You fall in love with a girl and you say, I want to give her a love letter or a rose. Woh mind mein achcha dikhta hai. When you go and give a letter, tab jaake thappad milta hai, kya hota hai, humko samajh jata hai. So mind to market is a very important transition that we all do. And this is this first challenge. Can Vada Pav become as successful as a burger? And the moment we did it, these are the challenges that came. Wastage, pilferage, and standardization. So I said, pilot, a limited paisa mein karte hai. You know, you have some 1 crore or a 50 lakhs, you will try and do the pilot within that, you know, unless you are Flipkart funding you or you got Mukesh Ambani's son, you know. Otherwise, your budget is always going to be limited. And a lot of challenges came. And out of 200 challenges, whenever you start a new business, especially on the consumer side, I'm saying, not B2B, B2C, there'll be different kind of challenges. And out of 200 challenges, we have to pick up 5-6, which will take the business to the next level. Somehow I felt, before us, there was not a single national fast food chain. Why? This was this question that was hurting me. Why not a single fast food chain, national across India, in 100 crores population? Looks stupid, but that's the truth. And wastage, pilferage, and standardization was what I zeroed in. Because sabere aap maal banao, shaam tak kharab ho jata hai. Wastage, pilferage, ek goli ka do goli koi bhi franchisee bana dega. Choriyan, India hai. Third, standardization. Agar cook bhaag gaya aur chef bhaag gaya, taste change ho jata hai. Imagine Coca-Cola ka taste daily change ho raha hai, Cadbury ka taste daily change ho raha hai, Britannia biscuit ka taste daily change ho sakta hai. But amare restaurant business mein hote rehta hai. So wastage, pilferage, and standardization was killing our business. And at this juncture, I said, can we solve the problem through technology? So we were the first people to look at technology for Vada Pav. And I tried ultraviolet rays from Amul, tried the nitrogen gas chambers like Lace and blast chill refrigeration. And all this, I keep on writing exploration and experiments with technology. Kafi paisa karcha ho gaya tha, and I was not finding solution. This all was working for Lace or maybe Amul, but not working for Vada Pav. And my banker used to say, Venky, Vada Pav to burger nahi banega, tu jarur beggar ban jayega. A lot of money was getting spent. And 1 week, he told me, Venky, stop the business. Business is great, consumer is there, but this is killing the business. Wastage, pilferage, and standardization. I told him, give me some time. And I went to back to the place where I stay in NRI complex. and it was raining and I was a little stressed because suddenly the business was going to a closure. My team was also tensed and we had some 15 stores running and there was a notice on my hand from the banker saying that ek mahine mein business band kar do and repay my money back. At this juncture, I went for swimming and it was raining and I saw a middle-aged Sardarji sitting under a canopy and I went to him. The moment I saw him, towel pain liya. As entrepreneurs, you'll go and talk to anybody to solve your problems, you know. My wife used to say, bikari ko galti se 5 rupaya diya to, usko bhi tum bhashan de dete ho, you know. That is the kind of thought process. You know, solution kaam bhi dhoondte ho. And the moment I saw only one person, it was raining and I couldn't swim because of the stress, I went and shared my story. And galti se Sardar ji ne bol diya, maybe I can help you. Aur koi entrepreneur ko kisi ne bol diya, galti se maybe I can help you and gives you your mobile number. 300 missed calls chala jate agla din. And before he could realize, the third day the Sardarji was at my store and he started seeing what I was doing and he saw wastage, pilferage and sanitization. Consumer was there. And he said, Venky, maybe I can help you. I said, what it is? He said, give me a month's time, I'll get back to you. I used to call him every day. After a month, he said, Venky, why don't you come to my factory? And I went to his factory. When I went to his factory, he gave me a packet and said, why don't you try this packet? And they fried that and gave it to me. And I really liked it. The taste was not like ours, but something. I said, who are you? He said, I am the person who makes burger patty for McDonald's worldwide. And my name is Vista Food. And we are McDonald's partner worldwide. For 43 years, we are in this. And with that, batata vada, which was normally done on the gutters of Mumbai, started being done with American collaboration, with every vada going through a metal detector and X-ray machine, and no human hand touching it. This was way back in 2006, we did it, five. And with this, batata vada, which was normally done on the gutters of Mumbai, started being done on a line where, on the neighboring line, burger patty for McDonald's was being done. So I told you the twin brother story, you remember? Huh? I told you, you find the purpose, the means will follow. And that's why I want to say, with this partnership, our wastage, pilferage, and sanitization problem got solved, and we had an American supply chain joint venture for Vada Pav. Imagine being there. We had a board resolution coming from Chicago McDonald's, from OSI. And for that, I want to say, you have a dream. The dream has come in the womb of the universe. It is the responsibility of the universe to fulfill the dream. The universe conspires to help you achieve your dream. You find the purpose, the means will follow. And these are the exploration, batata vada, manufacturing date, expiry date. Agar Chandigarh mein koi hamara vada pav kata hai, ya basti ya gonda mein koi khara hai, and if find something wrong with the taste, we know which plant the product came from, who was the supervisor, which cold room, which truck, or Punjab mein kunse farm se potato aya. Imagine trying to do a backtrack for a 10 rupee vada pav. That was the kind of thought process that we got. This was the logistics. These are the fryers. Fryers has got an important story. McDonald's fryers are 3.5-4 lakhs, you know. And we had our store which was being set up at 4-5 lakhs those days. And we couldn't afford those fryers because ours was a frozen product and Mac is also a frozen product. And they could afford those fryers. And luckily, I had met a lot of friends in VJTI, IIT. And my father used to say, every day I come home, your night you read that instrumentation book, engineering book. You know, I was trying to find technology for Vada Pav. So, utna padhai us time kar lete, engineer to ban jata tha tu. You know? So, as entrepreneurs, we are thirsty for knowledge. What is it? Thirsty for knowledge. Our background may be science, commerce, arts, or even 10th pass. But if you have a challenge and you want to find a solution, you will look everywhere. And luckily, I had these friends from VJTI, IIT. And ek Infosys ke bande ko chai pilaya aur vada pav khilaya, usne software lik diya. Ek VJTI ka engineer ne instrumentation kar diya program. 170 mein flame chalo ho jata hai, 180 mein flame bujh jata hai. Aur 15,000 mein hamara international level ka fryer ban gaya. Over a cutting chai and a vada pav. So very important that we collaborate with people and seek knowledge from a lot of people around us, you know, with paid or without paid. Dosti may be, ek chai may be chal jayega. And this is what, this was the fryer fridge. And with this, explorations became very easy. Frying became very simple. Now, solve the first problem. As entrepreneurs, our life is to solve challenges. The first problem was of the material problem or the product we solved. The second challenge, when I went back to the banker, abhi hum hai American joint venture, can I get more money? He said, I can't give you. You try and see if anybody can give you because you don't have any security. And at this juncture, I went back to Nariman Point, Bombay, to find whether there is some investor. And by that time, I heard a new name called PE, new animal in the world, private equity, venture capitalist. Hamare zamane mein us time nahi tha utna. And 2006-07, there were a lot of private equity. When I approached some of them, they said, Venkat, jindagi aage ja raha hai. Duniya Google kar raha hai, Facebook kar raha hai, Flipkart kar raha hai, aap piche kyun ja rahe ho Vada Pav? You know? So somewhere I said, I don't know, yaar, duniya aage ja raha hai, piche ja raha hai, I'm passionate about it. You know? And lot of our investors rejected. And most of these investors will stay in Trident, or they'll stay in Oberoi, they'll stay in Taj, or in Grand Hyatt. Aur unko Kalyan tak kon le jayega to show what we were doing. And I used to try some of them, galt, jor jabardasti karke taxi mein bita deta tha. Us din 2007 mein sab both flyovers ban rahe the. 2 ghanta tak to Dadar pahunch jate the. You used to get fed up and run away. You know, sometimes I used to try and push him into a local train. Oh, BD unko Dadar mein utar deti thi. So I tried some stunts to get some PEVCs to Kalyan. And some of them used to say, where is Kalyan? Is it in Mumbai? No, people never used to know Kalyan. And it was a 100 presentations. Salary was getting delayed. Vendor payment was getting delayed. My team was getting, you know, bored. And they're saying, kya hone wala hai? And some of them one day after 100 presentation told me, Venky, why don't you do some marketing or PR? Maybe somebody will give you money, you know, after 100 presentations. And I was coming back rejected. And I saw Times of India building. And I saw somebody drinking a tea and smoking cigarette outside Times of India building. I anuman laga shayad journalist hoga, went near to him and said, why don't you come to Kalyan and share my story? He said, come to my office and share the story and we'll see. So I went to Times of India upper and I was telling the story, why don't you come to Kalyan, blah, blah, blah. And he was typing something and he said, Venky, open Times of India tomorrow. And tomorrow, that was Mumbai's Vada Pav to get American touch was the headline. It was as simple as that. It was as simple as that. I liked it. I saw a journalist outside Kurla station. I went and shared the story, Hindustan Times. Tisra din, koi journalist ko Dombili station ke bahar dekha, Sakal. So it was as simple as that. We think, jeb mein 50 lakh hona chahiye, PR karna chahiye, kuch nahi hai. Sachche dil se chao, thoda sa mark aana ke liye tayar ho jao. 100 jan se baat karo, 5 jan chapwa dete hai. Are you all that simple as that? Can you have that big round of applause? I think it's getting tanda. And not only this, I saw Kurla station ke bahar bikariyon ke upar, no, somebody was making a movie and I saw NDTV. Taxi se utar gaya aur uske sath time share kiya. And my co-founder and my team used to say, sir, bikariyon ko tu bhi chhod do na. And when I shared it, NDTV within a week was national headlines. So getting media publicity was as simple as that. If you have a good story, if you are passionate, and if you are ready to take one or two wax on your cheeks, it's okay. Huh? So that's how. And the moment I did it, I didn't have to go to Nariman Point. They came to Kalyan. And I had some 20 people talking to me. And the biggest stockbroker was talking to me, India's. The biggest retailer, I just mentioned, he was talking to me. And somebody from Citibank approached me. And I said, wow, Citibank ka MD, ex-Citibank MD, IIT, IIM. Vada Pav ko ijjat milna jaruri hai. Agar Citibank ka koi banda aur IIT IIM ne invest kiya, to Vada Pav ko respect milega. We signed him, raised some 4.5 crores from 2-3 of his friends. And he said immediately, you know, this Citibank people are very big. And they say, Venky, 100 stores. 100 stores, 1 month I give you. You know, that's how they all talk. And I put a few stores, one in Dadar, one at Navi Mumbai. They were all large stores. And the moment Kalyan ka bada 15,000 tha, Navi Mumbai ka bada 1 lakh, Dadar ka bada 2 lakh. And suddenly, the real estate economics dawned upon me. We stalled the product problem, now was a real estate problem. And we did some 5-6 stores, and it was not working. 8 rupaya ka vada pav aur 2 lakh ka bada. And around that time, the investor told me, Venky, if you can't raise more stores at economical prices, return my money back. Return my money back. At this juncture, I didn't have any option but to give his money back. I said, give me a week's time. And I was moving around Bombay, Nariman Point, Gateway of India, and I saw this RA milk booth. Have you seen RA milk booths on the footpath of Mumbai? 1,800 of them. And 1,800, unko jaake pucha, tumhi kaay karta hai? Wo log bole, sakali don taas dood vikto, din bar kuch nahi karte. Aamne unko pucha, Vada Pav bichoge? And they said, jarur. And 300 RA booth ko aamne Goli Vada Pav mein convert kar diya, aur fridge aur fire ghusar diya. So what I'm saying, entrepreneurship is challenge, solution. Challenge, solution, and out-of-box thinking. What is it? Out-of-box thinking, very important. No employee will do it. You will have to do it yourself. And if you got an employee who is going to do it, he will become the entrepreneur. Are you all with me? So very important, out-of-box thinking, and besharamona, very important. And RA was such a beautiful thing, and my investor was very happy. The media was very happy. Suddenly people started writing much about Goli Vada Pav. And before I could realize, it was 2007-8, election year in Mumbai. And I was a Madrasi selling Vada Pav in Mumbai. And RA was a state government undertaking. It became the biggest political issue of 2008-9. This was the article that came in. And before I could realize, I was cornered into a political situation. Two of my stores got burned down. RA mein union ban gaya. I started visiting political people's office. My investor panicked. My American joint venture panicked. McDonald's ke upar kisi ne patthar feka. And before I could realize, I didn't have any option. I'm not elaborating what all we went through. 300 cases were filed on us. And I had no option but to withdraw from RA. So I raised money, and 6 months tacked, I spent that money, and I was back to zero. I had to withdraw from RA. This was the biggest low point of our life. Some of our investors suggested, why don't you sell off the company? I did the reverse. I went ahead and borrowed 3.5 crores at 28% interest and said, kuch to hoga. And my investor said, suicide. Family panicked, friends panicked. And I was waiting, kuch to hoga. And something happened to me in the next 1 year's time when everything was shut down, no money. I thought we'll raise a second money, but Lehman Brothers, Satyam and Subiksha happened. And that's why I borrowed at 28%. And yet Vada Pav survives. We were closed. There was a bankruptcy filed on us, winding up petition. And the judge had given a verdict, winding up petition, and went ahead and borrowed 3.5 crores at 28%. And upar dekha kuch to hoga. And one store came from Nasik for an inquiry. And this guy came and said, tumcha aata sona hai. And our office was wound up. 5 people were working. I said, kya chahiye? I want to start it in Nasik. We were reluctant, and we gave it to him. And said, aapko saman le jana padega. And he most probably came and took the goods from Nasik. And as he took the goods from Nasik and opened the first store, Nasik mein 10 dukaan khol gaye. Nasik mein kisne tobhi vada pav kaya, Aurangabad mein 10 dukaan khol gaye. Aurangabad mein kisne vada pav kaya, Jalgaon khol gaya. Jalgaon mein kisne tobhi kaya, Latur khol gaya. Latur mein kisne tobhi kaya, Parbani. 75 stores happened in 18 months flat. These are the stores. Maharashtra, Nagpur, Amravati, Akola, Pusat, Solapur, Barsi, Pandarpur, Kolhapur, South India, Bangalore, Mysore, Hubli, and stores expanded across India. Now you'll ask me what happened? When the RA milk booth happened, there is a political situation that got created. The political situation ran for 1 year's time. And in that 1 year's time, somebody from AC Nielsen called me up and said, Venky, why are you crying? Last ek saal mein, you have got media publicity worth 15 to 20 crores. I said, what is it? Because every day they used to show the brothers fighting, split, Vada Pav, and they used to show Goli Vada Pav on NDTV news channel, Star News, NDTV, Z News, Lok Satta, Sakal, and I was tense, so I never saw it. When we opened our email box, we had 3,000 inquiries from all over India. What do you call it? Everybody. So, Bhagwan ek aaj se darwaja band karta hai, to dusre aaj se darwaja khulta hai. I want to quote Columbus here. Columbus wanted to come to India or most probably Japan. He did his biggest mistake. He found a place which didn't have gold, which didn't have spices. And that was called America. Isn't America beautiful? Everybody said, Columbus, you did the biggest mistake. I did the biggest mistake of my life, RA booth. But if it was not for RA and political situation, Goli couldn't have become a national chain. So somewhere believe in the universe, somewhere believe that the universe is much more powerful than you. And that's what I want to say. When a lot of American universities started doing case studies on Goli, they said, Venky, what a strategy. I said, in US, we call it strategy. In India, we call it destiny. We call it destiny. So this was the biggest thing. And one more thing I wanted to say at this juncture is, from Mahabharata, I want to quote. You know, you have heard about Draupadi Vastraran? And in Draupadi Vastraran, You have seen that scene. Draupadi is crying with her hand on her sari. Hey Krishna, help me. Hey Krishna, help me. Did Krishna come? No. This is 99% faith. Ek haath sari ko pakda aur dusre haath se pooch rahi hai. And Krishna never came. When she left both her hand and surrendered and said, hey Krishna, help me, he came. This is 99% faith. This is 100% faith. 28% interest, 3.5 crores of borrowing. Everybody, huh? Everybody. So I wanted to say was faith. And Paulo Coelho has got a beautiful sentence in his book, Alchemist. The story of the world is written in one single sentence. The story of the world is written in one single word. And it is called courage, courage and courage. All those things that has happened on this planet, whether it may be Mahatma Gandhi, Adolf Hitler, Barack Obama, Dhirubhai Ambani, Narayan Murthy, or anything, that is only one thing. Courage, courage and courage. You have a dream, you have challenges, you have that courage to go through that fire. That is the only story of all stories that has happened on this planet. That is the only story. Nagpur, Kolhapur, Bangalore, Coimbatore, all this expansion happened. And Delhi, Hyderabad, Indore, 300 plus stores, 100 cities, 20 states happened on its own. So the most important thing that I wanted to say is, you have a dream. The dream has come in the womb of the universe. It is the responsibility of the universe to fulfill the dream. The universe conspires to help you achieve your dream. You find the purpose, the means will follow. Only thing the universe or Uparwala dekhta hai, tumme kitna dam hai, aur naya naya googly bail dalta hai, naya naya bouncer dalta hai. Googly aur bouncer fetch karke, tum pitch mein kade rahoge, aur bat nahi chodoge, to tumhara sapna jarur pura ho jayega. That is what I wanted to say. When this thing happened, a lot of these professors who did our case study, they asked me, Venky, did you knew it will happen? I said, I didn't knew. For that, I want to quote Amitabh Bachchan from Diwar. You know, Iftikhar comes, you know, Hitler comes. Iftikhar comes, he's the smuggler ka boss. Aapne dekha hai purana Diwar? And he comes and says, Vijay, first day of Amitabh as a smuggler, huh? That's a movie on smuggling. Diwar, old Diwar. How many of you seen? Wow. And Iftikhar asks him, Vijay, tum samajhte ho, tum ek kaam kar sakte ho? And Amitabh Bachchan gets up and says, main samajhta nahi, main janta hu, main kaam kar sakta hu. Samajhne aur janne mein bahut antar hai. So what I want to say is that, main samajhta nahi, main janta hu, main kaam, that's called confidence. That's called faith. That's called your belief in yourself. Are you all with me? And that's what happened to a large extent with most of the entrepreneurs. I've seen entrepreneurship failing. Borrowing 300 crores, coming back to zero, going back and building 10,000 crores empire in my life of 20 years of corporate finance. And all big dreams are achieved for people who have got courage, courage and courage. Our products evolved. This is more light. Huh? This is more light. I'm coming to the lighter version. As we started expanding outside Mumbai, Mumbai mein to sirf humare paas ek classic vada pav tha. To log bolne lage, amala franchises, no? Our franchises. Sir ji, more products chahiye, more products. तो बोला प्रोडक्ट्स तो नहीं था हमारे पास तो हमने एक चीज डाल दिया एक नया प्रोडक्ट बना दिया चीज वड़ा पाव शेजवान चटनी दिया और नया प्रोडक्ट आफ्टर सिक्स मंथ बोलते अरे का टोपी लावता गोली देता परत परत टॉपिंग वाढवता प्रोडक्ट चेंज करा ना एंड दैट्स व्हेन एवरीबॉडी अंडरस्टैंड्स मराठी एंड त्या वेळेला सडनली वी रियलाइज दैट वी नीड टू इनोवेट मोर प्रोडक्ट्स एंड देन सडनली वी सेड वी केम आउट ऑफ द पालक मकई फॉर बैंगलोर व्हेन आई वेंट टू बैंगलोर ऑल द पीपल फ्रेंचाइज यूज टू से कॉफी डे गिव्स यू कॉर्न स्पिनेच सैंडविच यू नो पालक मकई सैंडविच हमारा जो पालक मकई सैंडविच चाहिए आई सेड नो आई एम अ वड़ा पाव वाला आई विल गिव यू ओनली वड़ा पाव बोलते वड़ा पाव कौन सा कॉर्न स्पिनेच को वड़ा के अंदर डाल दिया और कॉर्न स्पिनेच वड़ा पाव बना दिया एंड दैट्स हाउ कॉर्न स्पिनेच सैंडविच केम फॉर बैंगलोर व्हेन वी वेंट टू यूपी लोग बोले समोसा चाहिए समोसा चाहिए बोला आई एम अ वड़ा पाव वाला हम वड़ा पाव देंगे समोसा का मसाला को वड़ा पाव में डाल दिया और मसाला वड़ा पाव बना दिया And that's how the products kept on evolving. What I'm coming to that is, when you went to Punjab, they said, Sarji, itnu sa vada pav pet nahi bharta hai. So we created Maharaja vada pav for Punjabis. You know, big vada. Wo log bolte, palak paneer de do. I said, no palak paneer. Paneer vada pav bana diya. So the products evolved as per the need of the state that we went to. Agar main Mumbai mein aisa vada pav bhejte hai, to kaan ke niche bajate the. बोलते ये थोड़ी वड़ा पाव है घर के, बट पंजाब में किसने वड़ा पाव ही नहीं खाया, वो पनीर वड़ा पाव भी खाया, पालक पनीर, पालक मकई वड़ा पाव भी. That's how we had a chance to explore with the products. And the way pizza chain has got variety of products, we also had a variety of vada pav. And whatever God did by kicking us in the ass and throwing out of Mumbai and Pune, we became a national chain. So a lot of times you have to believe on the universal energy and go with the flow. What is it? Go with the flow. Wo pani jaisa ja raha hai, flow ke saath. Bahut jan bahut bar kya hota hai, atak jate hai. Are you with me? Destiny ke saath jana hai with willpower is very, very important. Exploring marketing. Now I'm coming to marketing. We started doing marketing way back, but jeb mein kabhi paisa nahi tha. So 2005, I remember when we started the stores in 2004, I had a franchisee's son who did his MBA and came and said, uncle, marketing hona chahiye. I said, yes, handbill diya, baat do. He said, nahi, hum franchisee hai, union banayenge, TV mein advertisement hona chahiye. Main bola, TV mein ad diya to tumhara pitaji bhi road pe aa jayega, hum bhi road pe aa jayenge. But he was not ready to listen. He called a franchisee union, some 15-20 people. And I was standing outside Kalyan station. And I had to escape from that situation, you know. And I said, handbill. So he said, handbill? We have to do handbill. We have to do something larger. TV mein ad chahiye. Times of India mein bada ad chahiye. So I was waiting outside Kalyan station. 5 platform bid bari hai. And the announcement was happening. Platform number 4 ki gaadi, platform number 6 pe ja rahi hai. Krupaya yatriyon se nivedan hai ki platform number 6 pe chale jaiye. So I told this boy, beta tu idhar hi ruk jana. I took his father and one more person to the announcer and I told him, Tunnu ki mummy, aap koi bhi platform pe kade ho na, wo Goli Vada Pav ke dukaan mein aa jaye. Aapka beta Tunnu jo kho gaya hai, wo Goli ke dukaan mein kada hai. Can you have that big round? Ek baar nahi, do baar nahi, 5 baar announce kiya. Aur maine un sabko bola, Goli mein chale jate hi hai. The next aadhe ghante mein jo bhi train aaya, no, जो भी आधे घंटे में हम लोग रात को 10 बजे माल खत्म हो जाता है, उस दिन 7:30 बजे माल खत्म हो गया. वी ऑल लाइक्ड इट वेरी मच. नेक्स्ट दिन कल्याण स्टेशन में टुन्नू के बदले राजेश को गया, तीसरे दिन सुरेश को गया. ऐसा डेली नया नाम. 3 महीने का रेलवे अथॉरिटीज बोलते जो भी को जाते हैं वो गोली में मिलता है क्या, यू नो. वी हैड टू स्टॉप इट, बट वी डिस्कवर्ड अवर ओन यूनिक वेज टू डू मार्केटिंग, यू नो. वी डिस्कवर्ड अवर ओन यूनिक वेज टू डू मार्केटिंग. तो ये मार्केटिंग को लेके बहुत चर्चा होता था, बिकॉज फ्रेंचाइजी को फ्रेंचाइजी देते हो तो बोलता है मार्केटिंग चाहिए नो. एंड वी हैड टू फाइंड सम अदर वे ऑल्सो. सो अराउंड दोज डेज गणपति का टाइम ने एक बड़ा वड़ा पाव का गणपति बनाया हमारे किचन में, यू नो, 10 फुट का एक बड़ा वड़ा पाव, उसके ऊपर गणपति बिठाया और सबको वड़ा पाव गणपति का टी शर्ट दिया और पूरा नासिक डोल लगा के पूरा डोंबिवली में मिरवणूक निकाला. पूरा डोंबिवली कल्याण आके देखता अरे वड़ा पावची गणपति बघायला जाऊया करे, यू नो. द लॉट ऑफ पब्लिसिटी केम फ्रॉम लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंट थिंग्स दैट वी केप्ट ऑन डूइंग. And I remember अंधेरी में सब आप जाओगे ना तो यूपी बिहार से काफ़ी जन आते हैं, एक्टर बनने आते हैं, म्यूजिशियन बनने आते हैं. कॉफ़ी डे में चले जाओ, आधा घंटा कॉफ़ी पी के 10 जन से बात करो, उसमें से एक म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर होगा जो बनने आया है. उसको आप 15,000 दे दो और बोल दो आधे घंटे में म्यूजिक बन के चाहिए, वो टाइम लगाएगा 2-3 घंटा, बड़े म्यूजिक एल्बम बन के मिल जाएगा. वो कुछ जुगाड़ लगाएगा, एक नियरेस्ट स्टूडियो में चला जाएगा. और हमने एक सीडी बनाया उस जमाने में, केत गए बाबा बाजार गई माँ गरम गरम गोली तू कैले बबुआ, दिस बिहारी गई मेड बी फॉर मी, माझ्या डगाला लागली कळ पाणी तेम तेम गळ, चल ग राणी गोलीला जाऊन खाऊया वडा पाव, चोली के पीछे क्या है गोली के अंदर क्या है. ऐसा एक 15 मिनट का एक सीडी बनाया, हर रिक्शा वाला को बांट डाला और रिक्शा में जो भी कल्याण में बैठता उस जमाने में उल्लासनगर में, गोली 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 वड़ा पाव गोली म्यूजिक बज जाता. एंड उनको बोला कि महीने में एक बार आके वड़ा पाव अपने फैमिली के साथ फ्री खा के जाना. इतना फ्री पब्लिसिटी मिला. These are the kind of few publicities that we did. And those days, now I'm coming around 2009, we started expanding across Mumbai. And we couldn't do this, no, in across India. So I met a friend of mine called Sanjay Mehta, and he had come from the US. And I was telling, marketing is important. We have opened 100 stores in Maharashtra, Karnataka, and all. And everybody is bugging for marketing. Sanjay Mehta told me, don't worry. 2008, 9. And he said, there is something called Orkut. Abhi kuch Facebook aaya hai and I run a social media company. So he said, you have money? I said, I don't have money. Bolta raat ko internet pe baith ke jo samjha karo. So I started writing blog spot karke kuch banaya. Jab mein jab aadmi ka paas paisa nahi hota hai to creative ban jata hai, okay. And then I started putting something on YouTube and I started doing something on Facebook also, you know. Vada pav plus cutting chai plus amchi Mumbai is equal to awesome, you know. Raat ko 3-3 baje tak baith ke main karta tha ghar pe. to my father-in-law used to think, kuch toh gadbad hai, no? 3 baje tak kya kar raha hai, no? He had some other doubt. So that was the kind of passion we showed, even discovering the technology. And thanks to all of this, whatever I did those days, aur office mein bhi sabko bolta tha, time pass nahi ho raha hai, to Google mein jaake kuch toh karo. To sir, bolta, kya karna hai, kuch toh karo yaar, kuch toh post karo, kuch toh Facebook mein dalo. And before I could realize, 2011, somebody from Google came to us and said, you have won the best SEO award. I said, what is this SEO award? It's called search engine optimization. Jaane anjaane mein, ignorance mein bhi technology ke saath khela, uske liye tumko award mil gaya. Now, that is how this thing happened to us. Can we have that big round of applause? And thanks to Google, Goli became very big. Goli became very big because Aurangabad mein kisne tu vada pav kaya and fresh MBA rega aur he'll tell his father, mala Goli chi franchise gaye chhe. His father said, kutli company, yahan to bankruptcy tha, 5 jan kaam kar rahe the, 6 mahine se pagar nahi hua tha, vendor ka payment nahi hua tha. But Google mein jaake dekha to bahut badi company thi. Aurangabad mein ek 10 dukaan khul jata tha, Bangalore mein 10. So people knew us because of Google and whatever Google said. Arre evdi moti company asnar, brand evdi asnar, Google mein evdom ranking hai. And thanks to that, this is what happened when I was coming from Nasik. And Nasik se main aa raha tha, koi Marathi picture ka shooting ho raha tha 2009 mein. And my team member said, sir, aapli tar vaat lagli, tumhi shooting bagayla kute challe manun, those days. And when I went to that director, I asked him, picture kadhi release hote? So that tumhala kaya bhaije? And amcha kade 100 dukaan hai, 75 interior Maharashtra hai. Pusad, Nasik. And pratyek dukaan cha bahar tumcha poster lagaya, tumcha picture cha release cha. Ajun kaya? And sagge butter paper orti tumcha picture cha release cha naa hoel. दिवसाला एका दुकानामध्ये 1000 वडापाव विकतो. इमॅजिन 75,000 बटर पेपर सिंगल डे, एका महिन्यात किती बटर पेपर. काय पाहिजे? म्हटलं 10 मिनटं हिरो हिरोईन मीटिंग इन गोली वडापाव. अँड नवरा अवली बायको लवली वॉज द मूवीज नेम अँड हिरो हिरोईन वॉज मीटिंग इन गोली वडापाव का बस स्टॉप. अँड नाशिक में पिक्चर रिलीज हुआ, औरंगाबाद में रिलीज हुआ, पुसद में रिलीज हुआ. दे यूज़ टू सी टीम को एक ही बोला था, किधर भी मराठी पिक्चर का शूटिंग हो रहा है देखो और कोलैबोरेशन. एक 15-20 मराठी पिक्चर में गोली वडापाव का बार्टर हो गया. व्हाट डू यू कॉल बार्टर? व्हाट इज बार्टर? मे बी फकीर, तू भी फकीर, दोनों के पास पैसा नहीं है, बट वी कैन एक्सचेंज समथिंग विद ईच अदर. कैन यू हैव दैट बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज? बिग. एंड हाउ डज ही लुक लाइक? हाँ, सचिन ना. ये लुधियाना में वार्ड बॉय था, डेड बॉडी उठाता था. मैंने उसको देखा और किधर तो लगा सचिन जैसा है, तो उसको विग पहनाया, उसको गॉगल दिया और बम्बई में आके उसको नौकरी दिया. और गोली वड़ा पाव का कोई भी दुकान जब इनॉग्रेट होता है, एक गॉगल पहनता है, विग पहनता है, ऐसे ही दिखता है और गोली का टी शर्ट पहनता है. और बस्ती में, गोंडा में, इलाहाबाद, बनारस, लोग बोलते हैं साहब जी बस्ती में कौन वड़ा पाव खाएगा? मुन्ना ने बोला, फ्रेंचाइजी ले लिया, बस्ती में कोई खाएगा? ऐसा डरना नहीं, हमारा ब्रांड एम्बेसडर आ जाएगा. और जिस दिन दुकान इनॉग्रेट हो जाता था, जिस दिन दुकान इनॉग्रेट करना है, कानपुर, लखनऊ, छोटा सा शहर होता है, होर्डिंग लगा दो बोलते थे. फ्रेंचाइजी भी होर्डिंग लगा था, सस्ता होर्डिंग होता है, यू नो, 30-40 होर्डिंग. और दिन शाम को अराउंड 3 बजे वो एक ओपन जीप में जाके पूरा बस्ती, कानपुर, लखनऊ या औरंगाबाद किधर भी घूम के आ जाता था. शाम को 6 बजे जब दुकान इनॉग्रेट रहेगा, पूरा गाँव दुकान के बाहर खड़ा रहेगा, सचिन आला हाईला. एंड यूज टू साइन ऑटोग्राफ्स एंड फोटो निकालते थे और सब जन अपने घर पे जाके फेसबुक में फोटो डालते थे. ई हैपन टू बी सच अ लकी गाय फॉर मी एंड इट डिडंट कॉस्ट मी बट नथिंग, अ स्मॉल सैलरी टू बी पेड इन फॉर द लास्ट 10 ईयर्स. एंड ही हैज बीन डूइंग इट फॉर एवरी स्टोरी इनॉग्रेशन अक्रॉस इंडिया. इनफैक्ट व्हेन IPL हैपेंड इन बैंगलोर एंड वी वर पार्टनर्स विद पेप्सी एंड पेप्सी हैड स्पेंट सम 400 क्रोर्स टू गेट इन टू IPL, इफ यू रिमेंबर दोज डेज. एंड वी हैड अ स्टॉल, सो दिस गाय इज टू वेयर दिस टी शर्ट एंड टेक 50 वड़ा पाव, यू नो, एज अ ऑकर. He was not supposed to have other occurs, but he used to go to create that fun element. And the moment in that stadium in Bangalore, 4,000 jan kade ho jate the, Sachin aa gaya samajh ke. In fact, riot ho gaya, to Arsha Bogle ne usko commentary box mein bulaya aur bola, "Are, what is Sachin doing here when the match, Mumbai Indian match is happening in Mumbai, and this guy is eating a vada pav and singing a song, Goli 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 Vada Pav Goli on national television, and 10 minutes of this nonsense was happening. IPL sent me a notice saying that Venky, Pepsi has spent 400 crores to do this. Tum kahan se beech mein ghus gaya karke? Tab tak damage ho gaya tha. Tab tak damage ho gaya tha. Can you have that big round of applause? So this was a very important incident happened. I had gone to Thai to put up a stall, 2009. Kisne bola stall laga rahe hai, vada pav ka. And I was still bankrupt, still we were struggling. And they said, why don't you put up a stall? I went to put up a stall and the executive director told me, bhaiya ji, samosa, vada pav ke saath samosa, bhajiya aur chai bhi dena. I said, sorry, I can't give it. He saw a vada pav wala talking in English and he said, what is it? And I told the story, he said, tomorrow is our event. I am canceling one big guy and you are going to be a speaker. I said, who are the other speakers? He said, Mr. Ratan Tata, Narayan Murthy, Chanda Kochar, Kamath, Mr. Anand Mahindra, are you sure? And the next day, I had gone there with my slipper jeans and I was a speaker sitting to Mr. Ratan Tata. I was still bankrupt and behind there was something like 500 venture capitalists and private equity sitting there. And I wanted saying that maybe if I tell the story here, somebody will listen. And this was, my story was supposed to be on the third day or second day. Mr. Narayan Murthy and Ratan Tata was on the auditorium stage and Shekhar Gupta said one last question. Reluctantly, I put the hand up and they said yes. And I asked him one question. I had to leave Mumbai because of political situation. Mr. Tata, you had to leave West Bengal because of political situation. My investor, I go and tell them what to do. He says, you can't do anything. Mr. Tata can't handle politics. You won't be able to handle this. Mr. Tata said, I wanted to do something good for India, but, and he had tears in his eye. There was 5,000 questions and answers that were asked in that auditorium in the next 3 days' time in front of all these VCPs. My question and answer was telecast by NDTV and other television at least for 100 times the next 2 to 3 days. And out of that 500 VCP, one guy came to me and tapped my shoulder and said, Venky, I would like to invest in your company. He later on gave me 21 crores. So what I want to say, luck is meeting point of opportunities passing by your alertness to grab it. Luck is meeting point of opportunities passing by your alertness to grab it. Mujhe bhi laga, yaar, aisa sawal idhar kar sakta hai kya? I am not dressed appropriately. Maybe, but reluctantly, aath utaya, and that question and answer gave me my 21 crores of venture capital funding. Entrepreneurs ko yeki yaad rakhna hai, amay besharam sharam humse sharmaye. Amay besharam sharam humse sharmaye. And very important is critical thinking, imagination and communication. What is it? Critical thinking, imagination and communication. What is critical thinking? I somehow was able to find out this was Ratan Tata's story, this was Vada Pav's story. If Vada Pav and Ratan Tata ko ek level pe laake kuch sawal jawab kiya jayega, shayad kisi ka interest aa jayega. And you know, I want to tell you a small story. I was in LA to drop my daughter and in Sunnyvale I was sitting in a restaurant called Sangeeta, South Indian restaurant. And there was a Firang with me and there was an Indian also with me. And this guy was asking me, Firang, when you are eating idli, dosa and medu vada, what is this all about, you know, that Firang was asking me. And he had visited Sangeeta for the first time. And my friend who was from IIT, he was explaining for half an hour what is idli, what is dosa, how it is done and all. And this Gora Admi was still chewing his mind, you know. I said, give me 2 minutes. I said, this is idli. This is rice and lentil paste steamed like a momo. This is rice and lentil paste fried like a donut, medu vada. This is rice and lentil paste pushed like a crepe on a tawa, hot plate. It's called dosa. One single sentence he understood. I think as entrepreneurs, our critical thinking, our imagination, and our communication is very important. Either to our team, either to our vendors, either to our investors. I think that was the most important thing that I learned that day on this. Because I spoke that day for 30 minutes in front of Thai, I am normally a very reticent person. Ghar pe bhi wife is very powerful. Aath utana padta hai ungli baat karne ke liye, no? That is the background. Such, and then suddenly I realized because I was passionate about this story, I could talk in front of August audience. And thanks to that, I ended up speaking for 300 talks across India and across the globe. Thanks to that particular incident. And ISB did a case study on us. Most of the business school, IIT, IIM started calling me afterwards. And Indian School of Business did a case study. That case study became very famous. And Harvard did a case study. That became very famous. IMD did a case study. That became very famous. Switzerland ka. And then a lot of foreign university students started coming from abroad. They used to visit Infosys. They used to visit ICICI. They also used to visit Goli Vada Pav. All my teammates used to say, sir, pagar to time pe nahi dete, but gore logo bhashan zarur sunate. Very important is to keep the story going. Picture abhi baki hai, bahut zaruri hai. Paisa nahi hai, vendor bolta hai, kuch to ho raha hai, itna bhashan ho raha hai. Itna media mein aa raha hai. Okay, 6 mahine ka credit de deta hai. Employee 3 mahina rukta hai, dusra job dhoondta nahi hai. Franchisee bhi rukta hai. You know? So everybody, so as entrepreneurs, you have a dream, but your dream is in your head. But you have to articulate it to the outside world like a movie. And that's what I thought. I did it for 2 to 3 years. And jab tak mera 21 crores aaya nahi, aur jab tak goli next level tak nahi gaya, main apna bhashan karte raha, jiske wajah se case studies bana. Case studies banne ke baad, media cover kiya. Media cover honne ke baad, logon ka interest bante raha. These are the few newspapers they started writing about Goli. Pepsi came and became our partners. I said, ab Goli ka. Pepsi said, aapko kya chahiye? I said, sirf Pepsi nahi chahiye, commission nahi chahiye. I want something more. He said, what can I give you? I said, barter. What have we got to barter? I said, I'll give you 100 stores, 100 fridge. You give me 100 truck bags. So Basti, Gonda, Allahabad, Lucknow, Kanpur, Pepsi ka jo truck tha, uske piche ab Goli ka lag gaya. And ab Goli ka was India's famous dialogue. Which was the dialogue? Shole. And CP brothers sued me later on. That was a different story. But earth truck ke piche ab Goli ka laga. And thanks to that, we had this entire cartoons coming up. 20 states, 100 cities, 300 plus stores, 16 crores Vada Pav sold. That Venturis who came and met me in 2009 gave me 21 crores. There was a first board meeting for a Vada Pav company. Huh? There was a Deloitte due diligence for a Vada Pav company. We recruited people from Unilever, ITC, and McDonald for a Vada Pav company. Shailesh Haribhakti was Reliance auditor. I went to him and he became my auditor. And corporatization of Vada Pav at last happened in 2011 to 2013. And this is what India's most valuable company. Golden Spoon Award Coca-Cola used to give. Coca-Cola, this guy, Domino's got it for 3 years. Along with Domino's CEO, I used to stand there and get it from as a Goli Vada Pav CEO. And the last award was Starbucks CEO, Goli Vada Pav CEO, and Domino's CEO were on the same stage. And somewhere I felt I could give a position for Vada Pav amongst the burgers and the pizzas of the world. That was my dream. And that was my intention. Travel and leisure, it is the 18th best. CNBC said, it's a very interesting story, and they came and did a book on us, My Journey with Vada Pav. That book is available to hear. It's CNBC has published the book, and they say we want to promote entrepreneurship. Whatever proceeds goes from that book goes to CNBC, back to it. But this book has come out very well, and it's become one of the most popular book for entrepreneurs. And I go across the globe giving a talk on this book. And to the largest extent, whatever I spoke is that in that book. If anybody wants an autographed copy, I am ready to sign an autograph copy and a photo, and you can take this book. But I still say, picture abhi baki hai, mere dost. Kaafi kaam baki hai. What we have done is exploration, now we have to do operation. What we have done is the hunter's job, now we have to do the farmer's job. Brand building and organization building is a never-ending story. That's why I say, picture abhi baki hai, mere dost. Thank you. So wonderful, so wonderful. Thank you, thank you. Thanks. What a wonderful audience.
Good evening, sir. This is Anand. I have a question regarding the franchisee fees. Like when the brand is new, so how would the franchisee fees would be structured? What is your opinion on this? Whether it should be high on the higher side or on the higher side, I mean to say, whether we should recover the money in the franchisee fee itself or we should be more considerate towards the franchisee in terms of fees. Okay.
See, there are two phases to any organization building. One is a hunter's phase, one is a farmer's phase, what you say. And to a large extent, when you don't have money and you have a great idea, and if you think your idea can be franchised, that's the best way to grow. But franchises will never be under control in India's situation. That's a different story. But we started with 50,000 franchisee fee, then went to 75,000, then went to a lakh, then we went to 2 lakh, then we have gone up to a peak of 4 lakhs. But today we charge 3 lakhs as a uniform fees across India. And the total capex that is required is 10 lakhs, 7 lakhs on interior and equipment and 3 lakhs on franchisee fee. So he is able to recover in 9 months to 1 year's time his capital. That's the thought process.
Yes.
Namaste, sir. As you said that there were a lot of financial crunches.
Can you speak a bit louder, Sandeep?
Yeah. Hello. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. As you said, you shared that you were having a lot of financial issues. At that time, how you retained your employees? How you retained your core team?
Okay. I would say, I shared with you the whole thing. As entrepreneurs, you can be very transparent with them. People knew what was happening with the core team. I say everybody stayed where. Some of them couldn't handle, they left also. But I had this dream, I was passionate. I could see, you know, or thoda hi baki hai, no? Two more feet or gold mil jayega, you know. Two more feet and I will drink oil. But for employees and when the salaries are not there, it becomes a little, vendors also. But when I kept on telling the story, that story thing that came to me very beautifully, and I got a larger canvas, you know. Suddenly IIT calling you for a talk, I am giving a talk, Harvard doing a case study, media writing it. So the employees, the vendors, they found hope beyond you, you know. That helped us a lot to a large extent. And as entrepreneurs, we have only one thing. We have a dream, and we should be great storytellers if you are there. So you go to your vendor and tell your story, chemine ka udhar de do. You go into your first employee, say, I can't pay you 1 lakh fees. I can pay you only 25,000, you know. And you go to your investor or a banker and tell. So I think very important is the heart of communication. I wouldn't say storytelling. The dream, but how do you communicate to them and keep them together?
Good evening, sir.
Where are you?
1 or 2 years back, there was a controversy among two political groups about pakoda making.
I can't hear you.
About a couple of years back, there was a big controversy about pakoda making as an employment, or one group claiming that is a lowly job. I'm very curious to know what exactly went through your mind when you heard that.
Which group? Oh. So hota hi rehta hai. India is like a tamasha country. And bomb kahan se aayega pata nahi hai, you know. But I think I believed in only one story. Kitna bhi ups and down aaya with investors, with the court, with franchisees, with vendors. I say company is a going concern. Company cannot wind up. So as a thing, BCom mein humko sikhaya gaya hai na ek chapter, company is a going concern. So we used to always say company is a going concern. So ye sab aate rahega, political, ye wo sab. You should take your path and go ahead. Never allow other things to affect you.
Hello. Yeah. My question is, why is it that that profession is looked upon so lowly by Indians, whereas burger making is having a good dignity of job overseas?
I didn't get
you. Your voice is not audible. I think some sound system. You can speak without the mic.
Ah, that's beautiful, that's beautiful. So one of the most important thing for me was to, food industry is seen as a last resort. Jo ghar mein koi bhi kuch nahi kiya, padhai nahi kiya, to pitaji bolte hai, to vada pav bechega. You know, that's how, that dignity is not there. And that's why people like us, we said we'll get a Citibank MD to invest, we'll get Arvo to do a case study. So we as people, Indians, should understand the dignity of labor. Bavarchi is not a downtrodden guy, food is important, hum log khate hai. So I think that is there in India very strongly. Ki you have to get into IIT, you have to get into IIM. Boys means you can't become a chef. That is there strongly. But as entrepreneurs, we'll have to break that myth and go. You know, we have to rebuild that. That is there in India, surely.
Namaste. I'm Mahesh Rathi. Your success story is like our heartbeat. So always up and downs and up and down, but it's very inspired to all of us. My question is, are you have any plan or your roadmap to make it this brand as an international brand?
International?
Yeah.
See, India is such a big opportunity. What we have done is only a small thing within tight budget, within small investments and all. India mein 5,000 goli vada pav ho sakta hai. Ye country itna, I travel from UP, Punjab, Haryana, Orissa, Bengal, kahan kahan, I don't know where all stores are, Dhanbad, where all stores are there. And it mushrooms like anything. So this country is a great opportunity. Definitely, we have got inquiries from Dubai, so entire Middle East, UK, US, this will keep on coming to us. So we definitely will do equally international, but the biggest opportunity is India. That's what we want to do the whole thing.
Thank you.
So one of the biggest thing is that we got to do the frozen, but we tried the McDonald's machines to make pav for us, but it came out as a bun. In fact, customer ne bola ki pav garnered asel pan amala pavach paije. So we went across India and got people who are from Mumbai, you know, who are in Mumbai bakeries. Furkan Ahmed, Salim Suleiman, you know, typically lungi pehenke, unko jeans diya, t-shirt pehnaya, shave karaya, naha dhoya. और उनको हमने पाव का ट्रेनिंग के लिए गोरखपुर से लेके बैंगलोर से लेके चेन्नई के छोटे छोटे बेकरीज में गए और पाव कैसे बनाते हैं उनको सिखाया एंड लोकली पाव बनाना. थैंक्स टू गोली टुडे पाव इज अवेलेबल अक्रॉस इंडिया. वास्को डा कामा गेव पाव इन मुंबई एंड मे बी टू लिटिल एक्सटेंट टू पुणे बिकॉज ऑफ द कायानीज बस्तानीज बट वी टुक पाव अक्रॉस इंडिया एंड वी टुक वड़ा पाव.
थैंक यू.
हेलो. Second time I am hearing you, in fact. And
where did you hear me before?
It was on one screen. I was in one conference. And just to let you know that the whole audience gave standing ovation for that video, which we saw. It was in Goa. So, lovely. And same goosebumps again when I hear you. Very nice. Thank you very much for that. I just wanted to know, Goli Vada Pav became famous and Jumbo Vada Pav came in, right? So. First thing is, did you consider it as a competition? And if it was so, how did you overcome that particular?
A very important question. The word, you know, our business school puts that word competition as one of the most big word into our mind. It's like, you know, Sachin is playing cricket and he's practicing. And Sehwag is practicing and Ganguly is practicing. And if Sachin looks at Sehwag, how he's batting every 5 minutes, or Ganguly, what he is going to do, then you lose the sight of the ball. I think 80% of our time should go internally, and we should use our intelligence. 20% we should look at competition. I think there is nothing called competition. There is something called co-operators. Dunya Bhagwan ne sabke liye banaya hai. To tumhare liye jaisa banaya, sabke liye banaya. Wo bhi batting karega, tum bhi batting karoge, but tum tumhare ball pe dhyan do. I think that's one of the best philosophy that I have seen.
Thank you, sir, for such a wonderful journey you have explained to us. Every time I am the person, today sir said that I am always keen to ask the question. The way you have narrated the story, I was speechless. Abhi kya sawal puchu, mujhe dhun ke sochna pada ki sawal kya ho sakta hai aapke liye. To mujhe do sawal hai sir mere. Ek to aapne bataya ki you were working in banking sector aur aapke dimag mein entrepreneurship ka chal raha hai, business karne ka. What was the point कि आपको वो छोड़ के इसमें आने का और डिसीजन आपने कैसे लिया, क्योंकि वेल सेटल जॉब कोई नहीं छोड़ना चाहता, वो एक सवाल है.
तो वन इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग इज वी आई कम फ्रॉम ए तमिलियन बैकग्राउंड एंड यू नो पैसा ज़्यादा समझता नहीं है ना मद्रासी लोग को उतना, इवन मराठी लोगों ने तो एवडो पैसा आवड़त नहीं है ना. तो वी आर नॉट वेरी ग्रेट एंटरप्रेनर्स टू ए लार्ज एक्सटेंट. तो एंड टिपिकली द मारवाड़ी एंड द सिंधी कम्युनिटी दे आर मोर इन टू the business and the Gujarati community. I had a little amount of weirdo background. I got into corporate finance, but at the core I am a communist or a socialistic, you know. My father, my uncles, bachpan se kafi padha hai socialism ke upar. And I was always thinking about doing something good for India. And somewhere I felt if Goli ka 5,000, 10,000 dukaan ho sakta hai, 10,000 dukaan into har dukaan mein 10 jan kaam karega, to 1,00,000 jan ke liye hum log education provide kar sakte hai Goli Academy mein. Employment de sakte hai and entrepreneurship. Education, employment and entrepreneurship was that key purpose that I always felt will give Goli. In the process, we can create one idea today more than what you would say 1,000 people would be working in Goli, you know, directly, indirectly. So we are able to give that basic 10,000 to 15,000 rupees for more than 10,000 people. That I think one idea and so many people ka livelihood chal raha hai. That's beautiful. That's what inspired me to do this.
Okay. We have a couple of more questions. Yeah, Abhijit, and then we have Rahul, the last question.
सर जैसे हम लोग बिजनेस में ग्रो होते हैं तो हम लोगों को वर्किंग कैपिटल की बहुत जरूरत है. तो माय क्वेश्चन इज टू यू कि व्हाट कुड बी द आइडियल रेशो फॉर इन्वेस्टर फॉर प्राइवेट इक्विटी एज वेल एज वेंचर कैपिटल्स. क्योंकि नॉर्मली एंटरप्रेन्योर की सोच क्या होती है कि हम लोग थोड़ा प्रॉफिट के प्रॉफिट कैलकुलेशन वगैरह करते हैं. तो हम लोग कई बार ये सोच हमारी ऐसी होती है कि हमने बैंक से अगर लोन लिया तो 15-16% पे लोन मिल जाता है. तो एज अ प्राइवेट इक्विटी और वेंचर कैपिटलिस्ट वो लोगों की एक्सपेक्टेशन क्या होती है, हाउ मच वी नीड टू पे ऑन देयर रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट.
सी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल लिटिल डिविएट फ्रॉम द टॉपिक विच यू हैव सेड. वन मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग, there are two things that happen in our life, little I'm elaborating. One is analytics and one is imagination. I remember once one of the biggest IT guy was on the stage and I came on stage after him. You know, he's one of India's biggest IT person, and on stage he said, in God we believe and rest is data. He talked about analytics. I went on stage after 5 minutes and I said, analytics is like driving a car looking at a rear view mirror. Imagination is like looking into the windshield and taking it forward. As startup, we should have a lot of imagination. Analytics is very, very important, but you should do that balance between imagination and analytics. When you go to the outside world, earlier, before the Industrial Revolution, एक छोटा सा विलेज में एक आयरन एंड स्टील का आयरन स्मिथ था जो सबके लिए भांडे बना के देता था, और यूथ में या तलवार बना के देता था, चाकू बना के देता था. वन वीवर था, यूज टू वीव दैट टेक्सटाइल एंड इस पूरा गांव के लिए सबके लिए वीविंग देता था. एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप वॉज रेस्ट्रिक्टेड टू दैट विलेज. एंड देन सडनली वास्कोडा कामा केम, कोलंबस केम, एंड वी हैड अ ग्लोबल ट्रेड, ट्रेड बिटवीन इंडिया यूएस, ट्रेड बिटवीन इंडिया यूरोप. एंड ये ट्रेड के लिए भी उस जमाने में फाइनेंसिंग हुआ था. Some people used to call it banking, but those days also there were venture capitalists who used to take bet. ये ship के लिए मैं finance करता हूँ, आप शायद India जाके spices लेके आओगे और उसका profit में हम लोग बांटेंगे. And the same we see today, what we see, the banking sector is what changed that agricultural economy, you know, to industrial. All the big steel plants, all the big textile company of the Industrial Revolution got money from the banks, and the banks believed in the imagination of the entrepreneur. और उनको क्रेडिट दिया कि ये लोग माल बनाएंगे, बेचेंगे और इनको हमारा पैसा रिटर्न होएगा. दैट वॉज नॉट दैट इन द एग्रीकल्चरल इकोनॉमी. इन द आईटी वर्ल्ड, इन द व्हाट यू कॉल इन्फॉर्मेशन एज, द वीसी एंड द पीई हैज कम बिकॉज देर इज नो सिक्योरिटी एंड दे आर बिलीविंग दैट द फ्यूचर वर्ल्ड विल बी चेंज्ड बाई फ्लिपकार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड और व्हाट यू कॉल द गूगल ऑफ द वर्ल्ड एंड द फेसबुक ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. एंड दे आर सेइंग दिस इज अ कस्प. व्हेन द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन केम इट चेंज्ड एवरीथिंग. When the information revolution has come, everything is changed and everything is going to change, and they don't have security, so they are taking a bet on the consumer behavior. So the VCP wants a stake in your imagination and is taking that bet and is not asking you for security. And by chance tumhara upar niche bhi hoga to tumhara ghar bikta nahi hai, because he is taking a equity risk. It's one of the best thing that has happened to the world. Nahi to sirf Ambani aur Tata ji bhi entrepreneur ban sakte the. Because of the VCP world, you have today Flipkart, we have today Myntra, you have got today so many companies, Ola, you have got so many companies. I think that's the beauty. The unfortunate thing is that they have taken most of their belt in the IT space. But people like Goli Vada Pav has got funded, people like Paperboat has got funded, people like Quickil has got funded in Pune. So a lot of companies have got funding. So the VCP is one of the world, but they will not give it to most probably to your B2B, but give it to your B2C. इंडस्ट्री ब्रांड बन सकता है तो वो लोग दे रहे हैं आजकल.
थैंक यू.
ओके वी नीड टू या यू हैव अ लास्ट क्वेश्चन. चलो राहुल यू हैव अ क्वेश्चन. या फटाफट.
सो व्हेन अ न्यू आइडिया कम्स टू आवर माइंड एंड व्हाट वुड बी द राइट वे इफ द आइडिया इज वेरी न्यू. सो दिस इज अ ब्रांड आई वांट टू एस्टैब्लिश लाइक अ वड़ा पाव. इट वाज नॉट देयर अर्लियर. And the new thought that came into your mind, immediately you looked for the funding, or you had some trial and how it is, and see, what should be the right way of funding should be looked for?
To a large extent, in the industrial era, the private equity was not there. People used to build small businesses, do a pilot, take money from bank and then over a period of time scale it up, you know. So, but to a large extent, this question is being asked, is funding the ultimate requirement of any entrepreneurs? Are you with me? So, thanks in the last 10, 15 years, funding has become fashionable, funding has become very important. So, I think the first important thing is that how passionate about your idea, that is called dil se hai. And it's like you have fallen into with a girl and you are going to marry her and spend 30, 40 years, 50 years, you know, till death apart. Okay. It's like that, you know. So, if your business idea comes to you and you feel dil mein ho dhadkan, you know, that you can't sleep, butterfly in your stomach, you are going mad about it, talking about it, then automatically things start taking place. But I think first bet is apna paisa lagana chahiye. I put all my money. Then I put some friends and family's money. And then I took some HNI money, jo janta hai. And then I went for VC. Then I would most probably go for PE. So I think that funding happens in stages.
Okay.
A few questions from my side. And the last question from your side, then I'll have. Yeah, please. Do you have a mic for him? So that, take this.
Thank you, sir. Good evening, sir. Sir, I have two questions for you. One question is, I want to understand the business economics of demand and supply in the B2C market. Since you are into the main, the clothing, food and shelter business, that's the basic amenities of a man, and that comes to into B2C business. How does the demand supply chain affect your business, and what would you advise in once in a small gist to how we can optimize it? Yes, technology is one part, I agree, but then how do you actually optimize in terms of the raw material and the cycle of the production?
You are saying demand and supply?
Yes, because I assume that once you are into the B2C market, you the demand must be so high and we need to percolate the demand and match it up to supply. That needs to be generated in a very process-oriented way, right? So how did you manage to do it across 15, 20 stores at that first instance of your business?
Okay, first of all, coming to demand and supply, most of the products in the industrial age were uniform. Subjunct steel bana rahe, subjunct textile bana rahe, subjunct pharma bana rahe hai. Only thing that was giving them was the edge of technology. You know, amara topaz panama ka bhi blade tha and Gillette ka bhi blade hai. There is a huge difference in the technology and the joy that customer gets, you know. Colgate paste came, unhone Vico turmeric ya Vico ka jo Ayurvedic paste tha, usko kodo dus chod diya, Baba Ramdev ne aake unko ek jhatka diya, you know. All that thing keeps on happening. So I think on demand and supply, when the products all become same and the consumer feels sab kuch same hai, to fir wo brand ya us particular business ka kuch value nahi rehta hai. You have to fight the price war. It becomes a commodity. Innovation, packaging, marketing are the important thing. Innovation, that is a new product, which the consumer, like Apple, who would have thought, why should I pay so much for an iPhone? But there was an innovation, there was a packaging, and there was a marketing. And today people are ready to spend. Jab China mein iPhone to gali gali mein ban sakta hai, you know. But Apple stands out. So I think even in this world, modern world, the demand and supply, we have to create demand using new imagination. Facebook, it created a new demand. Amazon, it created a new demand.
And my second question to you, sir, is recently if you have heard, Coke is coming into the market of Indian drinks. So they are launching the Indian drinks. So they're launching their first Kairi Panna in Kerala.
Who is launching?
Coca-Cola.
Yes. That's what Paper Boat also did and a few other people are doing.
Yes.
There is no option for Coke at this stage. They are saturated the market. They have conquered the market world over. But the world is going through some changes. Okay. So they are also trying to redefine themselves.
Okay.
Great. So I think the questions ka silsila aisa khatam nahi hoga because the kind of energy you have given to them, they have so many questions coming in. I have a few questions for you. You not being from the hospitality industry or segment, was it a blessing for you to?
Yeah, it was a huge blessing because I never knew to make vada, neither I understood pav nor chutney. And there was initially a cook or a chef in my place, in our office, used to help me. But the first thing that I came to know was that जो चीज़ मुझे मालूम नहीं वो मैंने आउटसोर्स कर दिया तो वड़ा कोई और बनाता है अमेरिकन कंपनी चटनी यूनिलीवर का सप्लायर बनाता है पाव लोकल बेकरी बनाता है लॉजिस्टिक्स थर्ड पार्टी करता है फ्रेंचाइजी अपना धंधा करता है हम लोग ने सिर्फ ज्ञान दिया लोगों को एंड दैट्स द थॉट प्रोसेस सो इफ यू डोंट नो हाउ टू डू इट देन मोस्ट प्रोबेबली यू विल गो एंड आउटसोर्स इट यू नो एंड हमसे अच्छा जो बना सकते हैं उसको दे दिया इफ आई वॉज अ शेफ आई वुडंट हैव गिवन इट बिकॉज देयर इज अ जॉय इन क्रिएटिंग योर ओन प्रोडक्ट
And I think that that's a big message for all of us. The joy of doing something, if it's not there, then you should outsource it. I think same is the case with the team. Another question on the team front. We didn't have time and you couldn't speak about the team. More than you selling your dream and they're listening to the stories which you have been sharing with the world, say confidence build work, this company is going to go ahead and the only way up is up now. Mm. But apart from that, I'm sure kuch na kuch kiya hoga aapne, jisse second line, third line aapki rahi hai, so that they're able to handle the entire operations and execution.
Yeah,
so a few aspects which you can share with them.
Yeah, so to a large extent, if entrepreneurs thoda sa lazy rahenge to achha rehta hai. There are some entrepreneurs who would like to do everything themselves. I belong to the other category where I say, mere se intelligent aaju baju ke log hai. So from day one, there is a core team of 4 to 5 people. As we evolved and some of those core team members left, I got professionals who are there, but they are like core team members. And like you'll believe, the guy who's heading marketing is 15 years with MACD. The guy who's running my sales and operation West is again 15 years with MACD. So all the relevant people experience ko jama karna hai, which is important for your business. And you trust them for day-to-day operations. Believe in product. So I think the five, material management, manpower management, method management, marketing management, and money management. These are the five things. Money to a large extent was done by, you know, the investor and us together, but the remaining four was done by professionals. So, jitna jaldi aa sakte aapko bada dream hai, otherwise without this team, Goli wouldn't have become a 300 plus store. It's impossibility to run 300 stores with a one-man show. And I believe that hum jitna tanka lete, utna ya usse jyada bhi tumhara right-hand or left-hand aadmi ko milna chahiye. So I think developing a team is organization building, if you want to do something big and large. Otherwise, if you depend on yourself doing everything, it can be dangerous, you know. After some time, you'll get burnt out.
So when did this shift happen? So you started off, you didn't have definitely the good people or the best people the time when you started off. So for ye aapne people who are experienced, people who are masters in their own field, ye aapne kab lana chalu kiya?
So 2004 to 2007 was like all wherever I could gather. The first core team was working with me for 12 years. So after 14 years in financial services. So I said, one day I'm bored, I'm going to do Vada Pav. You all take the business and you run it. I have trained you, you people know it. I went to Kalyan and I started with one of the office pews to start Goli Vada Pav. Within a week, all the 11 people came, out of which 5 people stuck to me. And they started saying that, okay. So humne aisa pucha, isme se purchase kisne kiya tha? So I had never been to market in myself. So my office boy administrative said, dar mahinyala gharacha bhaji ani fish me anto. So you know purchasing, you take purchase. You know, that's how we started. Somebody else was great with people, he took HR. Somebody else was good with money and he became money. So all of them had financial services experience. So, but within them they had some personal traits, you know, in financial services. So we started with that. But as we started going towards 2009, it was difficult for me. The whole team would not allow the new professionals to come in.
Right.
There is always going to be a conflict. I lost some old team members as I tried to professionalize the organization. But I put my feet down and I got a professional team.
What you're saying is it's okay to lose some old hands?
Yeah, yeah.
If you have to get professional.
So I suffered also because I was emotional and I trying to balance the old team and the new team. But I think there is some good element in the whole team. But it has to be mixed with a new professional team, new energy, new knowledge has to always come into your organization. If the organization grow nahi hoga, sad jayega.
So that the entrepreneur has to agonize over this decision.
This decision, because the world will always resist the new. And there will be conflicts, there will be some people who will live, there will be some mess that will happen, but you have to go through that mess.
Awesome. On the investment side, you have had investors coming on board. So what kind of investors should we look at? Should we look at just pure investors or should we look for intelligent investors or what kind of investors we should look at?
Yeah, so I would say I was lucky also at the same time, sometimes unlucky also to a large extent. And investors, you should look from long-term perspective. So I was lucky enough to get the investor, but some that political situation, again investors, you know, bad relationship happened with the first investor because of that debacle. So you should look at investors who are here to stay, like I said about Sequoia or Axel or those kind of private equity people who are there. Even in good HNIs, there are so many good HNIs who come and support you. The one thing that you have to look at your investor is he going to stand by me? Because you are going to experiment and explore. A lot of things are not going to work. If during back time he pulls the rug, then that's dangerous for you. But even if he pulls the rug, you should have that ability to go down and come back again. So I think investors, anybody who should come to you should be with more long-term view. That's the most important thing. If they come with a 5-year horizon, 3-year horizon, it can be dangerous.
Great. And one last question from my, it's not a question, but I heard about your meeting with Mr. Bihani.
Yeah.
And something happened, something transpired in that meeting, something changed within you.
So with like Kishoreji, what had happened was, because during my financial services stint, I used to give money to meet entrepreneurs, hear their story, and go to the banks and arrange. So I really enjoyed that 14, 15 years of stint I was in financial services. The day used to start with meeting somebody, you know. So I came from a BCom background, and very average, okay. And somewhere I thought I should do financial services. Some of my friends who were chartered accountant challenged me, how can you do financial services? You're only a BCom. I worked in a small financial services firm. And you believe me, 14 years, my days to start wearing a tie, blazer. I used to go from Dombivli. But when I used to go into the big entrepreneur's office, I used to confidently look at his dream, understand him, and then he used to give me a mandate. And he said, go and raise 10, 15 crores for me. I used to go to a big bank, meet a chairman or AED, and I said, this guy wants this money. So there was no connection. I was coming in second class train, daily travel kar raha hu zamane mein, and going and meeting a 100 crore entrepreneur and telling him, I will arrange money, don't worry. And going to a banker and saying, don't worry, he's a good guy. Why don't you give him? But that was the kind of, you know, mental process I went through. And I enjoyed that 14 years meeting entrepreneurs. I will tell you, it's such a beautiful joy I had. My whole day used to be meeting entrepreneurs, meeting bankers, giving them crores of rupees. I was a socialist, so I never used to charge them very high fee. And I made my decent money. And I used to keep a cap. Saal mein 1 crore ban gaya to uske upar mujhe nahi chahiye. Remaining money, I used to tell him, aap dono mil gaya, aap log le lo karke paisa. So I came from a different breed. But that definitely, during those time, I met Kishoreji. And he was going through a process, maybe 50 crores turnover struggle. And I liked something about what he was doing and what he did. And I said, he's a madman, you know. And then Phoenix Mill happened. I remember Phoenix Mill was a dead city. It was a dead textile mill. And I remember Corporation Bank was telling me that that particular mill is going to be a defaulter. Then I will lose my promotion. I can't be the chairman. I'm a ED. And for TB Ruya, it was most probably, what do you call, a BIFR. So you would have lost that textile mill. Corporation Bank, it would have become an NPA. And Kishore Biyani was looking for cheap space. We just got all the three of them together, and Big Bazaar was born. So I think using imagination and that dead textile mill in Phoenix Mill, saap aa raha tha, plants grow hue the, has become Palladium today. I give a full credit to people like Kishoreji and Ruyas and the Corporation Bank who use that imagination, and today Palladium and Phoenix Mill is the landmark place. And Kishoreji is a madman, I always call him. You know, with nothing in his pocket, he built that 10,000 crores plus Big Bazaar. It was a great imagination.
Great.